Hi everyone, welcome to Python Learning Series for Network Engineers. In this video, we'll see how to use SSH key-based authentication from Python. In the previous video, we have seen how to generate SSH key and copy it to the remote machine. This is my primary Ubuntu machine. Here, if you go to home, the username and .ssh, you can see I have multiple IDs here. This is my default ID and we generated one ID manually here. For example, if you SSH to the secondary machine, the Ubuntu secondary, so you can see the hostname here, Ubuntu 02. Let me try SSH to secondary from primary machine, SSH user 1 at ubuntu2.test.lab. So you can see here I'm able to log in without any password because my Ubuntu 2 machine is trusting the SSH key of this machine. Now similar to that, here I have another ID with passphrase. We'll see that also. We'll see both cases, private key with passphrase and without passphrase, how to initiate SSH connection to remote machine using Python. This is one of the script which I have written earlier for initiating SSH connection. You can see here I have hard coded the username and I'm prompting user for giving password, and I'm using Parameco SSH client method, and here I'm using system host key. That means I already have that secondary machine in the trusted host list. We'll verify that also. You can just verify here. If I give known host, you can see here my Ubuntu 2.test.lab is trusted in the trusted host list. If I don't have that in trusted host list, I need to give set missing host key policy and auto add policy. But this is the recommended and safe method. Whenever you connect to a remote machine, make sure you are connecting to the trusted host. Now you can see the SSH connection method here. I am using username and password and executing these commands. I have explained this script in the Parameco's first video. If you want, you can have a look into that video. I'll add that video in the description and the notification. Let me just try running this script first. You can see here it is prompting for password. It is printing the password because of the ID behavior. Usually in the terminal, if you use get password, it won't display the password in the terminal. So you can see here, command is getting executed successfully with the username and password. Now let us try changing the method. I'll remove the password prompt and I'll remove password from here as well. Now let me try executing this script. Now you can see, though I haven't given password, I'm able to SSH to the machine because even by default when I initiate SSH, that is happening. But if you want to use a different SSH key file, how to use that, we'll see. So before that, we'll have a look into Parameco library. Here you can see one option. See, allow agent is true by default, and look for keys also is true by default. Let us set that manually here. Hello agent, I'll give false here, true is by default, and look for keys also, I'll give false here. Now let us try executing the script. So you can see here, no authentication method available. That means because of this value, it was true, authentication was working. Now we'll see how to manually map a SSH key file for authentication. For that, first I'll generate one SSH key here, SSH-keygen, and I'll give the file name 03_id. I won't give any passphrase. We'll see how to use passphrase later. First we'll see a plain private key. So you can see I have another file 03_id, private and public key. We'll use this file for authenticating to the secondary Ubuntu. So for that, first we'll define key file. I'll call that as a variable key file, and that it is an RSA key. So what I'll do, I'll just call this as RSA. You can see all the other options, parameco.rsa, DSA, ECDSA, all the types are there. This is RSA key, so I'm giving RSA key. Then let's go to the Parameco documentation. We'll go to key handling. Here you can see there is an option from class method from private key. Create a key object by reading private key from a file. So we'll use this. So RSA key dot from private key file, and I'll give the file name. It is home, the username is /.ssh/folder/, the private key file name is 03_id. Now I have private key created. Here then we need to give another value, it is called p key, and here we need to give this key file name. Let's see what is that. So here you can see you just need to map the private key file there, and here you can see one more option, search for, see you can see other exceptions what we get. If we use any passphrase for the private key in the pkey file, it will tell password required exception. Otherwise, if authentication something fails or file is invalid, you will get SSH exception. These are some of the exceptions. And here if you search for parameco.rsa, you can see the RSA key, you need to map it like that, and then DSA and ECDSA. Now let us try running this script. Since I haven't added this in the secondary machine, it should fail. Let us try connecting to the machine. So you can see here, I'm getting the message authentication failed because I haven't added this ID3 in the remote machine. Now let us try adding ID3 into secondary machine. So SSH copy ID -i 03 underscore ID to user 1 at Ubuntu to dot test dot lab. You can see here ID has been copied successfully. Now let us try executing this script. You can see now it is executing successfully. Now let's see how to use an encrypted password. So first I'll create an encrypted password. So I'll use SSH keygen and I'll create another ID 04 underscore ID and I'll give a passphrase 12345 with a password. You can see here now I have another ID 04 underscore ID. I'll try giving that here. Once I run the script, so you can see here password required exception I'm getting from Paramico. So if you come here and search password required exception which we mentioned earlier, now let us add that. Here I'll prompt user for giving the password. I'll create a variable key pass and I'll use get pass and give enter private key password, or even you can hard code it here. Then the syntax here is comma key pass variable we need to pass here. Now let us try running the script. Now it is prompting for password 12345. So you can see here I'm getting authentication failed. Let me copy the ID. And let us try running the script. 12345. Can see now command is getting executed successfully. Now let me try with the wrong passphrase. I'll give only 12. You can see private key checked did not match. So in this way you can use SSH key for authenticating a remote machine using Python Paramico library. You can use either password protected private key or plain private key. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. The next video will see how to use this key based authentication in Cisco DBS from Python.